One eternity later.
Well, that's a bit disappointing. Reading data is not going to set the world on fire, but it's a respectable 500 kilobytes a second. Writing is absolutely terrible, 270 kilobytes per second. We'd be much better off just disconnecting the SD card from the ESP32 and plugging it in directly. Surely we can do better than this. We're back looking at our tiny TV project. Thanks once again to the fantastic channel Patreons, and thanks once again to PCBWay for manufacturing the PCB we're using for this project and for supporting the channel. We'll be getting some new boards from them shortly. So, what's going on? Why is this so slow? It's certainly not a limitation of the SD card. If we plug it directly into my laptop, we get 26 megabytes per second writing and 90 megabytes per second reading. But we're not plugging it directly into our computer. We're running our ESP32 as a mass storage controller and connecting through that to the SD card. The ESP32S3 only supports USB 1.1 full speed mode. This gives us a maximum transfer rate of 12 megabytes per second over the USB connection. Theoretically, this could give us 1.5 megabytes per second, but there are overheads in the USB protocol. It feels like 1 megabytes per second is probably much closer to what should be achievable. We've also got the limitations of our ESP32 connection to the SD card. We're connecting to it using SPI, and the actual clock speed this connects at will depend on several factors. But with the cards and the wiring I'm using, I seem to get 20 MHz reliably. With better wiring, we might be able to get up to 40 MHz, but for that we'll need a proper PCB with an SD card slot built into it. Reading and writing raw sectors to the SD card, I get 1 MB per second write speed and 1.7 MB per second read speed, so it feels like 1 MB per second writing and 1 MB per second reading should be achievable. Now, we can of course use SDIO in 4-bit mode to talk to our SD card. That involves some extra GPIO pins, but it does give us much better performance. If we connect up a card in this mode, we get 2.34 MB per second for writing and an amazing 8.39 MB per second for reading. That's not bad. So why is our speed so slow when we connect the card over USB through the ESP32? 270 kilobytes per second is almost a quarter of what we should be getting. It's just not good enough. So to understand what's going on, we're going to have to look at some code. The code is actually pretty simple. We use the USBMSC class. This just needs three callbacks, one for writing data, one for reading data, and another that tells us when the card should be ejected. We initialize the USBMSC class by telling it how many sectors our card has and what size the sector is. When our callbacks are called, we're asked to either write or read data starting from a sector. The amount of data to read or write is always a multiple of the sector size. We write the data using the write raw function and read the data using the read raw functions on the Arduino SD object. These let you read and write a single sector. Unfortunately, these methods don't exist on the SDMMC class, so we're limited to SPI if we want to use the Arduino code. I logged out the actual size of the data we're being asked to read and write, and typically is 4096 bytes, which given our 512 byte sector size is 8 sectors. With the API we've got, we have to call the read draw and write draw 8 times. But if we drill into the functions far enough, we can see it's actually possible to read and write multiple contiguous sectors at once. The code is all there for us, it's just not exposed in a friendly way for us to use. Writing and reading sectors one at a time incurs a lot of unnecessary overhead. So I've thrown away the Arduino code and gone straight to the IDF functions. These are a couple of friendly functions, SDMMC write sectors and SDMMC read sectors. What's more, these functions work in both SPI and SDIO mode. In SPI mode, using these functions to write and read the data all in one go, we improve the write performance by over 70%. It's now writing at 480 kilobytes per second instead of 270 kilobytes per second. Our read speed has also improved by 32%. We're getting 671 kilobytes per second instead of 507 kilobytes per second. If we use the SDIO 4-bit connection, we get even better performance. We can now write at 0.66 megabytes per second, and reading is an incredible 1 megabytes per second. That's probably as fast as we can go over the USB 1.1 connection. It's a pretty amazing improvement from some very simple code changes. Reading is now performing as far as I think is possible, but it feels like writing could still be improved. so I thought I'd try something a bit dodgy. We don't actually need to wait for the writing to the SD card to complete before we return. What if we ran the writing to the SD card in the background and returned straight away to the USB controller? We would lose any proper error handling and will need to be careful to wait for the writes to complete before allowing any reading, but we could get quite a performance improvement as the transfers to the SD card could be overlapped with the transfers coming from the USB connection. So I've given that a go. With the SPI connection, we can now get almost 1 MB per second write performance. It's actually 915 kilobytes per second, which is 229% faster than our original 270 kilobytes per second. And it's 90% faster than our multi-sector writing method. With the SDIO 4-bit connection, we get similar results, so I suspect we've definitely hit the limits of what's possible with our USB connection. Obviously, there's no impact on the read speed. This stays pretty much exactly the same as our multi-sector read version. The big question we have to ask is this actually safe to use? And in answer, I really have no idea. We now have no error handling when writes fail, so potentially we could get our card into quite a weird state. But lots of hard disk controllers do buffered writing, so maybe it's fine. Is it good enough for our tiny TV project? Short videos, around 5 minutes or so, end up at 50 megabytes in size once they've been converted to AVI files. So to copy that to our SD card, we'd need about 1 minute. That might be acceptable, but to me, it's annoyingly slow. So we're going to need some kind of alternative. The simple solution is just to let people take the SD card out and plug it directly into their PC. And that's my fallback option. But I've got a slightly bonkers idea. There was a really cheap IC for interfacing SD cards with USB, the GL823. This will run over USB 2 at a whopping 480 megabits per second, which would give us much faster access to our SD card. I've also found a handy USB multiplexer switch, which is also really cheap. And I found another switch IC that will let us switch the SD card between the ESP32 and the GL823. It's got 6 lines, so we could run the ESP32 in SDIO 4-bit mode if we wanted to. Now, potentially, this could completely fail, but I think it's worth a try. The way I'm thinking this will work is that we'll start off with the USB connection routed to the ESP32 and the GL823 powered down or held in reset mode. We'll also have the SD card powered up and routed through to the ESP32 as well. If the user wants to connect to the SD card, we'll shut down the ESP32's USB peripheral and switch the USB connection over to the GL823. We'll then turn the SD card off and connect it to the GL823 as well. We'll then power up the GL823 and the SD card, and in theory, it should connect up to the computer. I can't think of any way of switching off this mode. There doesn't seem to be any signal from the GL823 to indicate that the device has been ejected, so we'll have to rely on the user unplugging the USB. It's a long shot, but I think this could work. The other option would be to transfer files using Wi-Fi and write them directly to the SD card, but I really want to get the USB solution working now, so keep an eye out for a new video where I build a new PCB.